Thank you. The Heifetz International Music Institute and its Festival of Concerts. More than 50 live concerts in Stanton, Virginia, and daily programs streaming worldwide. Full calendar and information at heifetzinstitute.org.
And with that, I can say welcome to Heifetz Chamber Music Concert number 2. Quite a showcase, and I can promise you that won't necessarily be the last time that you see all of our Heifetz students on stage. Just saying. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. What a wonderful opener to our Chamber Music Showcase number 2. And I promise you there's now chamber music, which is ahead next, which is one reason why Nicholas Kitchen is not with me right now, because he's about to play with the Borromeo String Quartet. But hearing this group, I think, is a really good reminder of a couple of things. You know, they call choral music and singing the first art, and there's a reason for that, and why it's sort of intrinsically connected to the DNA of the Heifetz International Music Institute. At the very beginning of the Institute, Daniel Heifetz felt very firmly that, in essence, that you can't really play the music on your instrument if you couldn't sing it. And ever since then, every time that a student comes to the Institute, one thing that we ask them to do, actually, is to sing the solo piece that they're playing. And as you might imagine, some sing rather better than others. but the whole key of that, though, is sort of understanding breath and tempo and rhythm all emanates from the human voice. So, and we've been so pleased to have Angel Lazara teaching voice for the last couple of weeks. And later in this program, you're going to have a chance to hear Angel and her thrilling voice in a solo capacity. You'll also hear her tomorrow night at the Rachmaninoff celebration as part of our celebrity series, celebrating the 150th anniversary of Rachmaninoff. So it's been quite a wonderful week here at the Institute, and we had a live concert this morning at the Stanton Public Library. Tomorrow we'll be at the gallery. We'll have the celebrity series concert, as I mentioned. And we'll be having our junior division students, who besides singing in our choir, have their moment to shine on Saturday, when they'll be performing both their chamber music as well as their solo pieces. That's at Grace Christian Church. It's absolutely free, and we would certainly love to see you there. So now I've actually shortened the intermission chat considerably. But we have an incredible performance by the Borromeo Quartet. We're so thrilled that they are in residence here to share some Haydn with us, and I'm sure Mr. Kitchen will have more to say about that momentarily. So thank you all again for being here and for enjoying the Heifetz Chorus.
Well, good evening. And first of all, I'd love to say that, at least for me, it makes me so happy to feel like the students have really joined together in that chorus that you just heard. And I appreciate so much that Angel's been teaching them about voice. And you know, the way we sing a phrase is somehow comes from our depths as a person. And I think it's just couldn't be more beautiful to actually join that together in something that all the students have done together. Well, we're about to join together in a way that we feel pretty good about too. And I'd love to say that I just feel so wonderful that my colleagues and I can play this role that we do as the quartet in residence at the Heifetz Institute. It is amazing to see all of what every group is doing with their work. Tonight, you're going to hear the first in the three quartets that are taking part in the intensive chamber music seminar. I don't know if he's somewhere in the audience, Shmuel Ashkenazi. I think he's up there. Thank you, Shmuel, for all these fantastic weeks of work. And the groups will play in the next few days. One of them plays tonight. The two other groups play on Monday. And then they'll switch pieces. And then they're going to work some with Mr. Ashkenazi, and they'll be working with all of our quartet. And you will be hearing them then at the end of the summer, bringing you the culmination of that work. Then we have the groups in the junior program. We have the groups in the senior program. There are 13 string quartets in the senior program. As I've explained a couple times, this year they'll be collaborating, each and every one of them, with faculty members. So we are having just layer upon layer of beautiful feeling of bringing this intricate and lively music together. No music is more lively and more beautiful than Haydn. But I'm going to kind of go out on a limb and tell you that, at least for me, Haydn has a similar strange sense of perception that is like the American interstate system. Now, why I say that is because here we're in our car. It's moving, 70 miles an hour, okay, 80, sometimes 85. But what I mean is it's zooming along in this incredible, smooth, straight line. Now, have you ever just noticed as you're going on the highway that you see the guardrail and that there are the very tops of the trees right next to the guardrail? Meaning that the ground is at the bottom of the trees? And then you go along and all of a sudden there's these incredible, fascinating rock faces that have been literally just blasted from the earth to make this smooth, totally seamless path for your car to go 86 miles per hour. Well, I think you may see what I'm getting at, that it appears to be so effortless and so permanent and as if it's always been there. And yet you contemplate that treetop and those blasted pieces of stone, and you realize that it is a phenomenal achievement to create that road the way we enjoy it. Well, why I say that is because, we get so used to referring to Haydn, and we somehow feel that he was always there, that it was always that way, that there was always string quartet as perhaps the most important chamber music form. There was always the symphony as the most promising place for a composer to show their imagination. We just feel like it was always that way, but it wasn't. He made it that way, all by himself, basically like 100 times for symphonies and 80 times for string quartets. And it's when you hear this piece, and I hope this will come across, we're going to play Opus 74, number 2. I hope that we will bring across that inside this one little piece that is one of the giant highway of string quartet creations that Haydn did, every little moment is cherished and explored and has as much humor as I can imagine anyone ever creating, and grand sounds and ingenuity and sweetness and joy. And, well, of course, it's great music, but it also gave us the foundation that leads to what every single one of those groups that is working here at the Institute enjoys as this treasure trove of music that can bring us together. So I just like to say thank you, Haydn, for doing this. And I hope that with that feeling, we can bring some of this, his incredible life, to you through this marvelous piece. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening. I'm Angel Azara, and together with Greg Ritchie, we'll be performing two arias. The first is Il est doux, il est bon, from Massenet's Herodiade, and the second is Ernani involami, from Verdi's Ernani. Both of these arias are about two beautiful young women who find themselves away from their immediate family and being predated upon by stepfathers. If you're familiar with Salome, Herodiade is the daughter of Salome, or Herodiade is the mother of Salome. So I will be singing the part of Salome. She's looking for her mother, She's been cast out of the house of Herod. And she talks to the square, to the people in the square, about this man that she has met who helped her find her way to her mother, John the Baptist. And she talks about how when he speaks, even the air is silent. Everyone listens and everyone's heart is calmed by his words. And in Hernani, Elvira talks about how her horrible uncle, Silva, is talking to her about love and about marriage, and she's spurning him for the love of Hernani, a young man who's currently roaming around the wilderness with a pack of bandits. So he may not seem like a great guy, but I promise, for a tenor, he's pretty good.
It is said. My name is Esther Kim. I'm 20 years old, and I'm studying at Indiana, and I'm studying here at Heifetz Institute, as you can see today. Today, I'll be playing for you Sigon by Maurice Ravel. Sigon means or refers to the Roma people, also historically referred to as the Gypsy people, and this is in French, but Ravel has just created an extraordinary short piece to portray all these intriguing colors for you guys today. So it is important to note that this piece does not directly like quote any authentic Roma music. However, Ravel has created this short piece to portray his own interpretation of the Roma music in his own fantastical way. This piece is just full of an amazing pulse and exciting rhythm, and you might almost find yourself wanting to clap along, although I would ask you guys to refrain from doing so today. But yeah, it's just so exciting, and it has an irrepressible type of joy and character to it. But it kind of reminds me of when I used to do track. I was not so good at running. As you guys can see, I'm playing the violin today, not running for you. But they would always tell you to go past the 100 yards, past 100 meters, and go to the end until you're like out of breath, you're ready to like faint. But today, Ravel kind of feels like my own individual track coach. He's really pushing me to go to the end. He might want the violinist's arm to fall off, although it's never happened before. So fingers crossed, nothing will happen. But I bring to you Sigon by Ravel. Thank you.
Thank you.
the Heifetz International Music Institute and its Festival of Concerts. More than 50 live concerts in Stanton, Virginia, and daily programs streaming worldwide. Full calendar and information at heifetzinstitute.org.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ariel, and I'm the violist in the Phoenix String Quartet. I'm joined on stage by Ilhom and Hyunji on violin and Elliot on cello. Tonight, we will be performing Mendelssohn's String Quartet, Opus 44, Number 2, in E minor. First, I'd like to give a little context about this piece. Mendelssohn composed this piece during a very flourishing, successful time in his life. His career was going really well. He had actually just gotten married, and he actually started composing this quartet during his honeymoon in the Black Forest. Of course, we all know Mendelssohn for his beautiful melodies, lively scherzos, and very elegant writing. But there's more to Mendelssohn than that. This quartet, in particular, dives into deeper and darker emotions like passion, longing, vulnerability, and at times, even hysteria. Before we begin, we'd like to thank our very amazing and insightful coach, Mr. Ashkenazi, for all the hard work and time he has put into our quartet. Thank you very much.